you 20.
Slow down. Running low on chips. I'll see your bet, and
I'll call.
Two pair, he's left coin.
Oh, lucky thing for me, I had three sixes. Sorry. Nice thought. Looks like you broke your losing streak.
I don't think that one should count.
Big boy?
I said, I don't think that hand should count.
You got any logical reasons why not?
My mind wasn't on the game.
Your mind? His mind wasn't on. What's your name, sir?
Johnny.
Johnny, Johnny, what's your last name?
John Harden.
What's your occupation?
I'm a gunfighter.
Well, I have to assume, since you're still alive and playing cards with us here, that, that you're good at it.
Care to find out?
Gentlemen, this hand definitely does not count. Here, you take it all. I mean, what is this? Well, everything's fair. I'll be content to leave. Do you mind if I just hang on to it?
You always been gutless.
Yeah, I think so. Well, for as long as I can remember it anyway. You know, my old pappy always used to say, he who fights and runs away can run away another day.
What? Look, I don't see what's happening. Whoa, son, there. Just slow down there.
Where's the fire, son? Slow down, don't shoot me, okay? I'm just trying to expound. I was just saying, I don't see what's so great about being brave. I mean, I'm a card player. I play cards, and call me a gambler. I want to become an old gambler. You, on the other hand, are a gunfighter. And an exceptional one at that, from what I hear. So if I decided to go up against you, I mean, what chance would I have had? Answer? Zero. Absolutely none whatsoever. Want to see it again? Damn thing won't stay in the holster. Whoop! Spring in there. Oh, come on, kid. Let's just play poker. Who here wants to play poker?
Yeah.
Who wants to see some guy getting killed? No. Let's play poker. I'd rather be rich than dead, you know.
Was that fast? I thought that was fast. Was it fast? Was it?
Yeah.
Now, what was it, stud? No, I think I prefer a draw. Just kidding. I'm sorry, son. I couldn't resist it.
Why ain't you?
Ladies and gents, it's Cyberland coming back to you with another film review. Maverick. So Maverick, I came across on HBO a long time ago, and I would see parts of it, but I never saw it from the beginning to the end. And then... But I did enjoy when I was watching it. At some point, I finally saw the whole film. And it's pretty much a Western. And it's got action, adventure, and it's a little bit of comedy. And the film is about a guy, Mel Gibson's character, Brett Maverick, who is not only a good gunslinger, but he doesn't come off like he is. He's a comedian. And he's a card player. And the film is about him trying to get to this poker tournament that's going to be happening, I believe in Louisiana, if I'm not mistaken. Could be wrong, but it's somewhere in the South. And he needs a certain amount of money to be able to enter. And that's what he's trying to do, make sure he has the funds. And also avoid Alfred Molina's character trying to make sure he doesn't make it there because they have a poker match beforehand and he beats him. And of course, Alfred Molina's character doesn't like to lose and he's a cheat. Along the way, he meets Jodie Foster's character, who he takes a liking to, as well as she takes a liking to him, but they tend to do a lot of arguing. She's also kind of a thief, low-key hustler kind of thing. So he deals with her throughout the film as well. There's a lot of cameos because this film is done by Richard Donner, so he has certain people in the film that are kind of cameos from other films he's done work with, or he's he's worked with other actors that are in this film. And then you also have James Garner, and he's kind of the voice of reason in this film. He argues a lot with Maverick on trying to do the right thing and such, and it's very understanding, but him and Maverick clash heads on multiple different occasions. But then once you see the end of the film, you'll get why that is. So you gotta watch the film to understand the reason behind it. I'm not gonna spoil it here. As far as the pace of the film, it was great. As far as the tension to detail that Richard Donner did with the characters, it was great. My rating for the film, if I'm not mistaken, my rating for the film, I give a 9 out of 10, yes sirs. Very entertaining. And for the most part, straightforward, but it has a little couple dips and turns in it a little bit, which is cool. I think, for the most part, the finale was like the best part of the movie. That was pretty badass what occurred. It was just interesting to watch. Besides that, there wasn't anything I didn't like. I mean, it's not a perfect film. It's just entertaining, and Mel and the other actors and actresses did a great job of doing just that. It was about entertaining the audience and having a good time while doing it. I would say if you've never seen it, check it out. I don't think you would be disappointed. But I would say it's not fast-paced. It's kind of trudges along. So if you're looking for something that's a lot of action, you're not going to get that. But if you're looking for kind of like a low-key, kind of reminds me of The Hustler to an extent. Paul Newman's Hustler. You know, it has kind of certain elements of that for me when I was watching it. Yeah, so with that being said, I definitely think you would enjoy it as long as you keep that in perspective. Yeah, so with that being said, I will catch you guys on the next one. Take care.